You kidding me? A 26-year-old telling me he got lost in the tube? Does he really want to be my friend? Such a weird man. He was a surprisingly warm and outgoing man. He started rambling about his stress for 19 minutes. He had breakdown if he failed exam. He went crazy when he saw the disgusting toilets. He couldn't express his feelings to his deaf parents. He didn't know how to live in a Muslim family as a gay. I felt I was surrounded by an intensive anxiety and sadness which made me feel suffocated. I could see his jaw tightened and then he said, "I have suffered from anxiety disorder for 4 years. I just don't have any friends. You guys are the first one I have in London. Thank you. Yes, thank you." He stared into my pupil with his amber eyes. They were eyes filled with guilt, sorrow, and something else. Something so bright, so vulnerable that made me realize I need to help him. When I finally find him, he gave me the same hug, so tight and so desperate. I couldn't help himself but kept repeating the same phrase with his trembling voice. "Thank you for saving me, Alfred, thank you," he said. I sensed something unusual behind his fake outs. I took him to a gay bar. I thought maybe it could help him, maybe he could have more fun here. So I purposely left him alone to give more space. But I was wrong. He vanished. I tried to contact with him, but he deleted his own social account. He once again fled. I was a bit angry. How could he disappear like that? I was just trying to do something good for him. It felt like he didn't take my good intention seriously and he didn't want my help. But at the same time, I thought maybe I pushed him too hard. I watched him running around cleaning his kitchen, repetitively apologizing for last night like a child waiting to be forgiven. A beam of light shining through the window. Air was filled with the sweet aroma of the tea. "It's peaceful and warm," sadly he said. "I'm sorry, I can't help myself sometimes," he murmured. "I'm not capable of anything once my anxiety kicks in. I can't even keep my promise." He was like a confounded man who lost his way. I didn't know who to trust, not even himself. I suddenly realized being a friend with a man in such pain is harder and more serious than I thought. Thank you. I felt I needed to leave, but he stopped me and wrapped me into his body like a drowning man finally found his life-saving plank. I was overwhelmed by this overly intimate contact with him. I even felt a bit uncomfortable. His desperate need for warmth and love is like a sharp scalpel cutting open my old wound. Through barriers, I saw the old me. So hopeless, so fragile, grasping onto every last hope and waiting for someone else who would come to save me. Do you to be the one sacrifice yourself for someone else? Do you to adopt an orphan and to be responsible for his whole life? Do you to be by an old man's side and watch him pass away? Do you dare? Can you? Or will you? What is selflessness and what is selfishness? Are you kind or evil? Are you willing to take or to give? Is love complex or pure?
Look at the stars.